Presented by Huawei smartphones. Great to have you along. Happy Thanksgiving. Brian Burke, to the point. You going to smile this time?
Maybe.
All right. We'll see if we can get him to smile a little bit. I know smiling right now, the Edmonton Oilers, right? A perfect 5-0. How do you explain this, the resurgent Oilers so far this year, Brian?
I think there's three things. Number one, new coach Dave Tippett has implemented a real sound structure in the defensive zone. They don't allow soft goals. They don't allow easy chances. So that's number one. They're keeping the puck out of the net better. Number two, they've got firepower that's almost unmatched. They can score goals. They've got lots of talent. That's working for them. And third is their goaltending so far has been really solid. Both goaltenders have been good, and they're putting it all together right now. Can they run the table? No.
There you
but,
go.
But can they hang in there and be in the playoff conversation in March? I think so.
Well, 82-0 would be impressive. Draisaitl, 24 minutes per game. I mean, Dave Tippett is really riding his big guns here. Do you feel, forget about running the table, but do you feel this is actually a legitimate playoff team? Because no one predicted that.
I don't say they're not there yet, but I think they can be there. And they had a good schedule to start, even though they had some road games. The big boys in the West haven't really gotten rolling yet, but that's going to happen. So it's going to be harder for them, but I think they can stay in the conversation and be in the playoff hunt.
And the real deal has been the real deal, James Neal. How bad are the optics, though, for the Calgary Flames? That fan base, there's a bit of hand-wringing going on, knowing it's Lucic for Neal, and Lucic hasn't had a point yet.
Well, Lucic has started two fights that changed the course of the game. So, again, let's start at the very beginning. You evaluate trades with a calendar, not with a stopwatch. And what the instantaneous reaction is, oh, my God, look what James Neal is doing. So remember, the Yashin trade, when that first happened, everyone said, oh, the Islanders won that trade. The two guys that went were named Spezza and Chara. The trade didn't exactly work out. Herschel Walker was traded for 5 players and 6 draft picks, lasted 3 years with the Minnesota Vikings. So this is far from over. Calgary got what they wanted. They got toughness, they got size, they got leadership in Milan Lucic. They got the Oilers to eat 12% of his contract when they have some cap issues, and they got a safety net third-round pick if he has a big year, which he's clearly doing. The fate of these two teams will be the ultimate arbiter of who won this trade, not which player outplays the other. The success of the teams will dictate this.
So you made some fair points there, but if he scores 40 goals, the optics aren't going to look great for the Calgary Flames in many respects.
They're not going to look very good for the Calgary Flames, and I hope James Neal continues to play like he's played. Good for him. He was a square peg in a round hole in Calgary. He never would have done it there, but he's taken this new opportunity, playing up higher in the lineup. He's got a new lease on life. He came to camp in great shape. Good for him.
Brian, have you ever had a situation where the optics look bad and you're getting the scrutiny of the public, the fans? Yes, you have. That's an easy one, right?
Yes. I remember acquiring a player by the name of Phil Kessel and then watching my team plummet in the standings so that the first-round pick we gave up turned out to be a kid named Tyler Seguin, who's turned out to be a pretty good NHL player. Now, we got what we wanted. Phil did everything we asked him to. We never envisioned that pick would be that high. And back then, teams didn't lottery protect their teams. I should have thought of it, and I didn't. And I was called an idiot in 17 languages all season long.
All right. Listen, being a GM's a tough thing. 27 GMs have been replaced since 2014. Are any GMs you feel, even though it's early in the season, pressing the panic button already?
Well, I think you try to get 10 games in, including a road trip. And that's what your yardstick would be. You're not going to panic on 4 or 5 games. But after 10 games, or if it's the end of a road trip, 12 games, you're going to look. And so, for example, the 2001-2002 Canucks, we started off 3-8-1. And I talked to Mark Crawford, and I said, I think this team can still win. He said, so do I. So I had a meeting with the team. I said, I believe in you guys. I promise you I won't trade anyone in this room for the next 20 games. You guys get your act together. That team finished with 94 points.
Do you think some of those discussions are taking place already?
Absolutely. By the 10-game mark is when you'll have those talks.
Those are tough conversations to have, but I guess the only other option is to move the coach, and that's pretty premature at this point.
Pretty early, and again, if your coach has a great track record, you're really reluctant to do that. Remember, as a GM, you usually only get to change the coach one time. The second time, you get the walking papers.
All right. As always, Brian Burke to the point. Thanks. A little smile. A smirk, if nothing else. All right, Vancouver, they're smiling right now. Brock Besser finds the back of the net for the first time this season.